That brings us to a question from Deputy Chair Assembly Member Arbour, which is on traffic issues at Kew Green.
Thank you, Chair. Local residents have every right to make their views known to Richmond Council about this and other decisions, and it's for the Council to consider all the feedback they receive, both positive and negative, as part of its decision-making process. The proposals stem from a larger Richmond Council scheme to review parking across the North Kew area following the redevelopment of Brentford Football Club Stadium, which has resulted in increased parking pressure in the area. Richmond Council also temporarily suspended parking along Kew Road in response to the COVID-19 pandemic to extend the operating times of the cycle lane, which was previously only operational from 8 a.m. to 10 a.m, with parked cars allowed in the cycle lane outside of these hours. The current layout is temporary, after which the Council would need to undertake a permanent traffic management order if the measures were to become permanent. The Council has emphasised that the Elizabeth Gate has always been listed on the Kew Gardens website as its preferred drop-off point for coaches, so they've taken steps to ensure this can be accessed in a safe and convenient manner. TfL has been working with Richmond on these proposals, including where they overlap with the TfL road network and how the Council and how the cycle lanes will link with Cycleway 9 at Kew Bridge.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Have you visited Kew Gardens?
Quite often. Oh, you mean recently? Recently. Not in the last few weeks, no. The last time was probably a few months ago when I visited as part of a planning application.
Well, can I urge you to come again and visit Kew, especially in lilac time? It's not very far from Clapham. And when you go, you will notice that the traffic conditions are not as you described when I asked you about this in September. In September, you said that Kew Road was a busy cycle corridor and that Kew Green was a quiet backwater. You will see that neither of those things are true. Currently, when we don't have the COVID situation, though nevertheless the gardens are open, visitors who don't come by train come largely by coach and are dropped off in the Kew Road, which only has buildings on one side. It's a very substantial road and the coach is parked there. The current proposal, which I would suggest to you really is linked to Richmond Council's obsession with cycling. I mean, it's a feature, isn't it, of Liberal Democrats that they are as keen on cycling as you are and TfL are. And they are suggesting that the buses, the coaches, now park at Kew Green at the Elizabeth Gate. This is a UNESCO World Heritage Site. If those coaches can only drop off people at Kew Green, they're going to create enormous pressure on the traffic and the residential area, which is Kew Green, and is going to have an appalling effect on that. Can I sort of wrap up other things in this? You've mentioned Brentford Football Club and the pressure that, again, when they are playing properly, that will have on Kew Road and Kew Bridge. Can I say that the terrible delays, which is still being caused by the closure of Hammersmith Bridge, are only going to exacerbate this? So far from being a quiet backwater, Kew Green is going to become a very substantial traffic hub. The coaches which are to be diverted around Kew Green are going to have to come out onto the South Circular Road. They're going to have to go on to Kew Bridge, and this is going to cause very substantial disruption. Can I ask you, please, to reconsider your advice to Richmond Council on this one and say to them that the coaches should continue to park in Kew Road? I fear for your reputation on this one, Mr. Mayor. It's an unusual thing for me to say. Currently, Richmond Council is getting all the blame for this, quite rightly, but I fear that if you give this one the nod, you will get the blame, the GLA will get the blame, and coincidentally, I fear that I may get the blame as well. Can I ask you please to look into this one?
Chairman, the member is assiduously raising legitimate concerns from local residents. And I always take on board what he says. I mean, he's hugely experienced in these issues. He's right to remind me and those watching, this is the Richmond Council scheme. But there are concerns. And so why don't I ask my walking and cycling commissioner to speak to the council, Kew Gardens and Assemblymember Arbour. Will Norman does speak to residents as well, to see if there's a way to navigate the various interests here so we can get to a resolution that satisfies as many people as possible.
Well, thank you very much. Navigate is a very good term for this. And again, can I repeat to you and to all members, do come down to Kew in Lilac Time. Thank you, Chairman.